That's Booby.
Gulpy and Chip and Ghosty. And if you're interested in getting a Ghosty, Black Plord. Wait, why is there no P on that? Okay.
Black Lord.
Yeah, it's not Plord.
Black Lord at papa.emeritus.plushy.
Yes, I had a friend with the last name Plord, so.
Everybody in Maine, their last name is Plord.
Okay, so we got a package in the mail.
Yes, sir.
For a while, actually, we've had it.
That's right.
So, now we'll open it. Vin, take it from here.
Who is this? Is this some Stew Mal?
Yeah, I believe so. I mean, I'm not sure for sure because it. I don't see a name on it, but
you're not he sure told for me, sure.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. He told me that he sent something. Holy moly, they really put that in there good. I'm glad you didn't just pop right into it, because then I would have been like, that makes me look really weak.
Everybody knows that you're strong. You see Orion?
I know. My father was like, it's just he's holding his arms down and I can't...
can't lift them up!
He's just...
So, we had... It's this last little
I know,
string of
and
tape
you know
right
what?
Here.
The thing... What, just rip it across this way. Like that. There we go. We should have used those things that Zonia gave us. What is this? Ooh!
Is that a Tremonti shirt?
This is a large, so stop trying to take mine. Small for me. Oh my gosh. Man, Tremonti makes some cool shirts.
I know,
shirts.
He really does.
What?
Alter
oh, you
Bridge.
Got an Alter Bridge
I've got
one.
An Alter Bridge shirt.
And I got a Tremonti.
This shirt is badass. Thank you so much, Stew Mal.
Yes. I've been taking my band shirts that people send me and like cutting them different ways to make
yeah.
them more interesting.
Get the little 80s style thingamajiggy.
I like it.
You're a badass, that's for sure. Thank you very much, Stew Mal.
I thought you thought it was weird because you never say anything.
What do you mean?
The way that I cut the shirts, you never comment.
No, I like it. I like it.
So I'm like, oh, he must think it looks weird. Whatever, I like it. So.
Speaking of where in the world is a village, it's a big homie, Neil.
Neil
has a unique...
We did a one of those collabs with him.
We did?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we did. And it's him, and then there's you in the background. He looks scared to death.
Yeah, I know. It looks creepy to have me behind him. He's like, it looks like yeah. I'm like, shh.
And imagine having to wake up every day to that.
How rude. I dreamt that somebody stabbed me and I was
Fear.
Bleeding out of my leg so fast and I was calling to you.
I wasn't gonna help you.
You didn't come.
I wasn't gonna
Why
help
Why didn't you come? You came once the bleeding had stopped. You were like, see, you're fine.
Yeah, you gotta learn to, do it on your own.
Actually, I think that is what happened.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is what happened.
Yeah, well, that was the conversation last night. Alright, Symphony of Destruction Megadeth.
Yes.
This
With
should be interesting.
Headphones.
I know. This is going to be very, very interesting.
Are these called headphones?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
What else would they be?
I don't know. Like,
huh?
I don't know. Headphones, it just seem like such an old-fashioned.
Okay.
I don't know.
Symphony
I don't know.
Symphony of Destruction
guys.
Megadeth, let's go.
And go.
Whoa.
Come on.
That was a good one.
What I really, really liked about this song is that the chorus was melodic, but the melody was carried through the guitar, not necessarily his voice. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, we've always, you know, went back and forth about Mustaine's voice, but this one, they let the guitar really carry the melody for the chorus so that he could kind of, you know, speak it out without mm-hmm. trying to sing. Because early Mustaine, when he tries to sing, it just, in my mind, it doesn't really work. But, good Lord. Okay, what'd you think?
I liked it. I think it was pretty obvious what it was about.
What was it about?
Well, we talked about the Pied Piper and people being, like, led through the streets like little rats. He said at the beginning, you take a mortal man and put him in control, watch him become a god, watch people's heads a roll. You just put somebody in leadership and they just goes right to their head and then people's heads start rolling, you know? Or you've got, you know, and then, you know, the Pied Piper thing, because people will follow a leader, like, I was going to use the word religiously, but
yeah.
I guess that's an appropriate term.
Yeah, they
so,
will. That's control.
Yeah, so even sometimes if someone, you know, is doing the wrong thing, people are still going to roll with them just because it's their leader regardless. And instead of, like, thinking independently and stuff, but, like, and then what happens to a, you know, to some leaders when you give them control is that it goes straight to their head, and then here people's heads are rolling, you know what I mean? Like, I took that literal, like, when they the guillotine, you know what I mean? Like, here's rolling heads, you know? So,
yeah. Well, I mean, it's very hard not to make a modern day correlation.
I know.
Where, you know, Trump is, but it's really funny because I remember when Obama first got elected,
yeah.
The whole narrative from the right wing was, this kid has no experience whatsoever, all he was a community organizer, he doesn't know anything.
Yeah.
So it was like, you're just putting this, you know, random person in here. And then, it's same thing happens with Trump. Now, mm-hmm. Trump is different because Trump actually had a lot of experience with politicians and politics.
Mm-hmm.
Namely, buying them. And he would say it. He would say it during the debates. He'd say, I donated millions of dollars to your thing, Hillary, and, you know. So, like, it's really amazing. Like, every group, they look at the other guy like he's just some oaf.
Right.
It's the same thing that happened with Bush. As the left tried to characterize Bush as just this idiot, you know, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same thing with AOC. Like, anybody that gets that, you know, I think, like, a show like Game of Thrones was very instructive because it's like, say what you want, but it's very to be able to maneuver yourself into that seat, it takes a certain level of genius.
Yeah,
it really, really does. And so, like, anybody, I say it all the time, like, people say, oh, AOC is an idiot, I keep seeing all these memes, I'm like, okay, well, go ahead and do what she did
then. Right, right.
Like, I'm not necessarily a fan of her. I'm not a fan of any politician, per se.
Mm-hmm.
Except for Jesus. Jesus absolutely was a politician, for sure. You know, like, anybody, especially in American politics, anybody that can maneuver themselves into those positions are extremely intelligent, calculating mm-hmm. people.
Yeah.
And you can say whatever you want about it, but, like, oh, so supposedly Bush was this idiot oaf. How did he get reelected then? Serious question.
Right.
How the hell did he get reelected? Well, he's such an idiot.
Because they're saying, like in this song, they're saying it's the Pied Piper thing. You're just a bunch of rats running through the streets. I actually think that they're insulting us.
Well, I mean, yes and no, I think. I mean, because whoever's political side you're on, the opposite group is always going to say that the other guy's the Pied Piper.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, of course.
So
yeah.
when Obama got elected, it was, oh, this guy, you're just voting for him because he's black and blah, blah, blah. It's like, well, then how'd he get reelected?
Yeah. No, it's true. I mean, even, like, remember that whole situation that happened and, like, everybody was like, oh, Sori's not thinking for herself. She's just letting Vin think for her
and
stuff.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
If I would have gone with their side, they'd been like, yeah, that's
right.
Good.
If you would have said something pro-abortion, they would have been like, that's right, girl.
Right.
You stand up for your
right.
man, blah, blah, blah.
Right.
Yeah. But, I think Game of Thrones is very instructive, and it gives you a new appreciation for how difficult it is to really ascend to powerful positions.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just having money. You know, Hillary's campaign had, like, they were outspending Trump like $4.50 to $1. So it's not just money. And the thing that Trump did, was the genius of Trump, was he was able to manipulate media for free.
Yep.
Because he knew anytime he posted something,
some tweets and whatever, and then it would blow up. People are like, Trump just said.
Right. So you'd be interviewing Hillary or Ted Cruz or whatever, and Trump just put some craziness up, and they'd be like, what do you think about this? And
it was smart.
And they were all mocking him like he was some buffoon, but at the end of the day, who's got the Iron Throne?
Right.
And if Antifa keeps up their BS, he's going to have the Iron Throne for another 4 years. So, you know, it's like, it's very, very interesting. But on the other side, Trump was the only politician that was vocally encouraging physical assaults at his rallies.
Right, right.
And then saying, I'll pay your
lawyers.
That was
a problem. That was a problem, like, for sure.
So, even though I'm saying the other group is always going to say the other guy's a Pied Piper, like, he legitimately... I think at the beginning didn't know how to use his power properly.
I agree with that.
And, you know, I think he had some stumbles, but it's sometimes when you're a powerful, influential person, you really don't know how much power you actually have. Like that's one of the problems with influential people is many influential people are not aware of the fact that they're that influential.
Yeah.
And so what happens is they say things and then it happens and people will like come after them and it's like, what are you talking about?
Right.
But you know, speaking of Trump, if you want to talk about a symphony of destruction and war and heads rolling, he made the right call with Iran. Right? Like.
Oh, I totally agree.
He made the right call with Iran. And politics is such a fascinating look into the psyche of people.
Yeah.
Because you had people on the left and the right criticizing Trump for not bombing the hell out of those people and killing 150 of them.
Mm-hmm.
Which was a lowball number.
Right.
And it's like, wait a second here. I thought Trump was the crazy psychopath.
I thought that was the most reasonable human thing that he did. Like, I say human because I feel like that when you get on such a massive scale for numbers, you know, X amount of people dying, this many people trying to come into the country, this many kids getting killed in abortion, there's so many numbers, and then you lose track of, like, that they are actually people.
Right.
And so when he said that, I felt like, I don't know, like, I felt calmed inside. I was like, oh, people are important to our president.
Well,
and I understand that there's sometimes... like, losses have to be made for the greater good. I hate that, but I think that sometimes that has to happen. But, like, it was unnecessary. Yeah, they shot down a drone. So, you know, would just be unnecessary to kill 150.
They have national sovereignty. You can't go into somebody else's air. Like, I love America. But you don't get to stroll into somebody's airspace and expect them to just...
Right.
And they warned them multiple times. They warned them. They're like, yo...
We don't want any smoke.
Get your drone out of our freaking country. So it's like, you know, that's why, like, I don't jump on the left or the right. Because they can't be honest.
Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of leftists want to characterize Trump as this crazy psychopath and all the rest of it. But we all know what Hillary would have done in that situation.
Oh,
she'd have bombed the hell out of those people.
Absolutely.
She was saber-rattling at the freaking Democratic nominations. You know what I'm saying? So it's like...
Yep.
With career politicians, numbers like that don't matter.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, if Hillary, the question would have been, how is this going to affect me in the polls?
Right.
It wouldn't have been, how many people are going to die? It would have been...
Right.
How is this going to affect me in the polls?
Yikes, that's really terrible, but yeah, I agree.
That is exactly what she would ask. Trump is like, okay, how many people are going to die?
Mm-hmm.
And he even said it. He's like, even though I'm America first, in this particular instance, we weren't going to benefit from it, and we're going to kill 150 people. For what?
Mm-hmm.
He's like, it's an unmanned drone, forget it.
Yeah.
Now look, I don't think, you know, when during the Obama administration, when the Iranians captured those sailors, I don't think they would do that with Trump.
Oh, I agree. I don't believe that would have happened either.
They wouldn't do that.
Yeah.
Trump would be like, yo, somebody, like.
Yeah.
I, pacifistic Vincent, I saw that. First of all, I was pissed at the guys. The guy was all crying, and the women were there like, yeah, whatever. And the dude was out there crying. I'm like, what the hell, man? Like, come on, bro. Like, did you go to Sierra School? They teach you how to die with honor. Like, what the hell is wrong with you? But the problem is that when your commander in chief is Obama, you're not particularly sure that he's gonna do what you mm-hmm. need done.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's the thing is, you know, with Obama, it was, you know,
yeah,
he wasn't a real like America. Like, if you got caught behind enemy lines in the Bush administration, it would be like you'd feel confident.
Mm-hmm.
But Obama. But with Trump,
you're confident. You're coming home,
man. Listen,
yeah.
So it's a very interesting principle, and I'm sure there's a lot of Trump-hating people that would be like, yeah, this is Trump. And it depends on what mood you catch him in. You know, when he was, and I think, yeah, I like to think people evolve, and in the last 2.5-3 years, he's evolved. I think in his re-election campaign, I don't think he's going to say, you know, mm-hmm. to act violently and I'll cover your legal fee. I think he's, like, grown past that now, inshallah. Mm-hmm. And I think the characterizations of Obama as this just stupid, you know, community organizer, like, Obama got stuff done. Like, he did what he said he was going to do for the most part.
Right.
The Obergefell decision happened on his watch. So he did some, you know, and he got Obamacare, you know, passed. And, of course, you know, Trump's working on do that and all the rest of it. So my point is, some of this, though, is kind of like, you know, deep state stuff, like a shadow government stuff, you know, like. And that was a major conspiracy theory during the Bush administration because mm-hmm. he was such an idiot, quote unquote,
right.
that the
right.
real president was what's his face? The really evil guy. Forgot his name. His vice president was a real president or whatever.
I don't remember his name.
But I'm not particularly sure that at this point in our country that you could even have a shadow government.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think you could have one in the 60s or whatever, but I think, like, people don't realize it is very hard to keep a secret. All these conspiracy theorists, sometimes I sit back and I'm like, you think somebody kept a secret like that for 30 years?
Oh, yeah, I know.
Really? Like, it is extremely difficult to keep a secret. And there's a lot of disinformation yeah. and all the rest of it, so.
Because everybody wants to tell that one person that they trust.
Well, yeah, and then the more exclusive the information is, the more difficult it is to keep that secret.
Right, right, yeah.
Because, you know.
You could.
You
could keep it a secret.
Well, it's different, though.
Why?
Because I've never had access to, you know, who killed JFK or blah, 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 blah. Like, people have, like, misunderstandings of like how much people actually know. Like, stuff is very, very segmented and extremely, mm-hmm. you know. I texted my brother. I was like, all right, now tell me who killed Tupac.
What did he say?
He's like, well, but he was just like, yo, like, it's not like that.
Uh-huh.
You know, I'm like, well, you guys are domestic, so, you know, this is the. And then he'll go, well, who, you know, and I'm like, argh. You know what I mean? So, it's not like that. So, I just don't think at this point in time anybody could ever have a shadow government. You have way uh-huh. too many factions and things like that within a government. That's the other thing that people don't realize when they think about shadow governments. Like, it's not like there's a super secret cabal in the background and they're all united.
Right.
It's human nature.
Mm-hmm.
So even though you do have guys that are powerful in the background of these whatever, in these alphabet groups, like, they have different agendas and different motivations
yeah.
that motivate them, and there isn't, like, four people in a room that think the same way and think this needs to happen in this way.
Mm-hmm.
Period. On anything.
Yeah.
So, that's why I personally don't believe in any of this Illuminati, whatever, whatever stuff, because it's just completely contrary to human nature. These people are, like, you know, androids or something.
Mm-hmm.
Like, they can all keep secrets. They've got the secret thing that's been going for hundreds of years.
Right.
They can all keep secrets. They establish these policies. And then they agree on which a politician, they just agree in total about which politicians to set up, and then they agree into which one. Stop it.
Right.
No. No. Generally speaking, what you see is generally what you get as far as who's in power. Now, the spin on certain stories and the media being allowed to report on this and that, that's true. But as far as, you know, who's in power and all the rest of it, they just basically, you know, I mean, that is what that is. But it is a scary thing about human nature. Good Lord. You know what I mean? Like, people are so easily influenced by one charismatic person. And when you say charismatic, it doesn't, like, Hitler was different than Stalin is different than Obama is different than Trump, but they're all massively influential people. Mm-hmm. And the charisma manifests in a bunch of different ways. Mm-hmm. And so, like, you know, like, Hitler had the anger. You know, and Obama had that smooth, I'm an accessible black guy, but I'm cool enough to, you know, I'm cool enough to, so, you know, that you could feel down with the struggle. And then he had the thing with his shirt off on the beach. And, you know, like, yeah, Trump is a different type of attitude. Trump is like, I'm ignorant and stupid, and I'm going to say whatever racist thing I want to say. And,
why do you do that voice, babe?
It is what it is. So, I mean, it's just different. So human nature is pretty crazy because you can't really predict who people are going to follow. Like, if I would have told you, like, you know, 4 years into the Obama administration, Trump's going to be the next president.
Nobody thought Trump was going to be
Trump's going to be the next president. He'd be like, come on, bro.
Yeah, nobody thought that was going to happen. Everybody was saying the same thing. There was no way in the world. Honestly, I can't believe, even myself, I was surprised that it happened, so.
Yeah, it's bananas. Like, you, it's human nature. You can never know. You can't know who the next guy is. There's probably some.
Well, part of the thing is people say one thing, but they're thinking another thing. So that's why the numbers were all showing it was going one direction.
Oh yeah,
the voting was happening another direction.
Well, yeah, and that's why, you know, Hillary was silly enough to, you know, underestimate Trump and not do her due diligence and go to those
places. Yeah,
states, exactly. Because she was looking at the polls because everything about her.
Everything about her
is about the polls, and it's 2019. Like, that's not the way.
Honestly,
it works.
Honestly, too, I think that people's pride kind of got in the way. Like, probably her own pride. You know what I mean? Like, remember when which I think we're both seeing the situation differently, but the kids were outside playing football and there was this really excellent player, like he was like a miniature Edelman, and he was like holding the football, and then Johan ran up to him and went to grab the ball from him. Johan is our 10-year-old, and he goes to grab the ball from him, and the kid was like looking at him like, and Johan like fought and grabbed that ball and took off and made a touchdown.
Well, he didn't make a touchdown.
Oh, he didn't make a touchdown. No. He got really close.
It was a clutch play.
Yeah. So it was like, I think he underestimated him. Like,
he did.
I've said this a bunch of times. I never heard you say he did.
He did.
But I think that's what happened with Trump too. Like, Hillary was like, please, I'm not going to lose to that guy.
Oh, they all did. They were all making fun of him.
Right.
It was a giant joke the entire time. You're not laughing now.
Look at what happened because you have pride.
Yeah, well, and the next one.
You think you're easily better than somebody else.
That's the thing. That's why the women's soccer team beat Thailand 13-0.
I think that's part of the reason why she wasn't able to come out.
They weren't gonna. Who?
Hillary.
Oh, of course. Of course.
It's just too much.
Yeah. That was a big thing. It's like, you can't sleep on anybody. You know, you're in the hood. That, you know, people used to think, oh, why'd you go, you know, Sharif used to put people in the hospital. People are like, oh, you're going overboard. He's not going overboard. There's three of us.
Right.
There was three of us.
Right.
And there's nine of those guys.
Right.
So you're going to engage that differently.
Right.
So, you know, it is what it is. So, I mean, good Lord. Yeah, human nature is scary as hell, man. And the thing is, people don't, like, if you were to talk to a German and you would have said, look, in 2 years, somebody's going to show up, and he's gonna make you turn on your neighbors. Mm. You're gonna destroy all their shit. You're gonna kill them.
No.
Okay. But it happens, you know. And that's why, like, it scares me when the somebody says, oh, so-and-so is a Nazi, and people just roll their eyes. Like, on the one hand, I'm like, yeah, it gets used a lot. Like, somebody says Trump is literally Hitler. Trump is not literally Hitler.
Right.
On the other hand, people act like those German citizens in the 30s and 40s were, like, from Mars
right,
or something
right.
like that. They're regular people.
Right.
And most people can be influenced by a very charismatic leader
yep.
if the external circumstances are conducive to that type of behavior. And if they know how to tap in to the prevailing angst of your current zeitgeist, then
yep.
it's gonna get ugly. Good song. This is one of those songs that you can apply it pretty much every generation.
Mm-hmm.
Right now it's applicable to Trump, though. And I think we've successfully pissed off Republicans and Democratic listeners.
And we've accomplished our job.
Our mission. What do you get, song?
I think I'm giving it a 10. I think it's, yeah, 10.
Yeah, I think it's a classic level song.
Yep.
I'm giving it a 10. I mean, really, it's first chorus, middle, you know. But the reason I'm giving it a 10 is because of its, you can put this in the vault and open it up 20 years before 1992 and 30 years after and it'd still be relevant.
Yep.
So, very good. Good job. Good job, Mustaine. Hmm? Been out.
Sorry, out.
Gone.